Hey, what's up everybody around the world? Welcome back to another tutorial in Revit's Global Knowledge. Today I'm going to show you how to create an amazing facade design in Revit. As you can see here is my project reference before we jumping into our project. We got our steel structure for structural support our facade design, and we got for our panel facade. If you are looking for closely, we got two different material for that. For these three guys over there is just a wire mesh, and the guy over there is a white color, is aluminium composite material, is alugabound. So if you want to know how to create this kind of facade design from start to finish with a structure element here, make sure follow up from stick around together from start to finish. And I would like to keep the project remaining first. Let's speak into our project together because I don't want to be wasting your time. And don't forget to thumbs up, like and share if you like the tutorial, and you are a first time to read here, make sure you subscribe. Okay, as you can see here is my level 1, is another Revit architecture template, and for the previous 3D there will be keep reminding here. So what I'm going to do first, I'm going to create some floor first before we create our structural element or facade element. Facade component. So I'm going to our architecture tab on my toolbar there, then simply press our floor, use our floor architecture, then simply using for rectangle I will try start drag up like this and make it for 20 meter by 20 meter, hit escape a couple time, then I just hit finish up. And of course I need to assign for a new material as well. I'm going to make it for white color. Okay, so I tie it out for gypsum. Then it's okay. Okay, perfect. Once I done my material and my floor, I would like to open my sound elevation first because I want to create another floor. Just like my level 2, then AR for shortcut key for array. Start from here, make it for 4 meter, then I will tie it out for 9. Let me see first. I want to tie it out for 10, hit escape first, just like my floor there. Go to our modify and floor, copy to clipboard, then pass, align to select level. I'm going to start from level 2 until level 11, hit OK. Once I done that, I go back to my level 1 there, go to my masking and size, then select my mask, in place mask. Then simply using our pick line, I'm going to pick from front here, hit escape a couple times, select my front that line that I create for mask form, create form, solid form, go to our sound elevation. I would like to drag it up here, just drag it up until top, and here I'm going to make it from the level 2. Of course I need to divide surface also, divide surface, and I'm going to open node here. Then of course I need to adjust my property as well. I'm going to make my facade panel is 2 meter by 2 meter. Change this one to 50 stand as well. Perfect, hit apply. Okay, so everything is perfect with our Revit architecture template for our project. So now it's time to create our structural element. I'm going to our file there. Then go to new, go to families as away. English again for metric, and in the case we can using our adaptive component, but I don't want to wasting time to press 4 point, so I prefer using for metric component pattern best. It's got 4 point element for adaptive component also. Once I select that, Revit will be transfer me to another pack here, and of course I need to adjustment my size also, make it same as our project, 2 meter by 2 meter. Once I done that, I can go to reference, go to place from top of our adaptive component. Just place on top of them, hit escape a couple times. Then I'm going to select all of them one by one. I want to assign associate family parameter as well. Just go to our property panel, then finding for offset, assign for a new parameter, create new material, then make it for parameter for offset structure. It's okay. Once I done that, I'm going to my family tie. Then I'm going to offset about 800 millimeter. Hit apply, then hit OK. Then go to my reference again, plus our point, plus on top of here, or I need to plus here. It's OK first. Then I can select here. Start from our right side there. I'm waiting for move that. I'm going to move it because I want to make my facade more interesting a bit. Then I'm going to move here also. Just move in for 1.3 meter as well. Once I done that, I'm going to assign for a new material parameter as well. Create new material. Make this one for offset facade. It's okay. Go to my family tie there. Then I'm going to make it for 300. Hit apply. Perfect. So what I'm going to do next, I'm going to place my element there. So I'm going to start select from first point, second point, splice through point. Again, we just continue our process. Okay, sorry again. Okay, once I done that, I'm going to create our panel. Just go to set a plan, set for horizontal, then start using for our rectangle. Start from here until here. Hit escape a couple of times and make sure you turn on for rectangle is a reference line. Okay, perfect. Once I done that, it's time to create our facade. So I'm going to select here 1 and 2. And this 4 guy over there, I will make it for is a reference line as well. Then start from here 1 and hit a tab key 2 and 3. Create our form, solid form, make it for surface and continue that. Just continue our process here. So I select this guy over there. Maybe I'm using for the big one for ACM or aluminum composite material and assign for a new material. Before that, I need to create a new material. First, create new material and just rename it for ACM. Appearance library. We're using for metal here. Then I'm finding for, let's say I want to make it white color, so I prefer go to wall pen using for cool white, then hit apply, then hit okay. Again, I'm going to select another 3 guy over there, 1 and 2 and 3 over there, assign for a new material as well, create new material. Rename it for wire mesh. Use this guy over there, aluminum mesh. Hit apply and it's okay. Let me edit first. Appearance, I want to make it more or less here. Apply. Okay, so now material is updating, is quite long. Okay, I want more like this. Okay, I like this one. It's okay. Okay, once I done that, let me turn for realistic first. Is it fine? In some case, you could not saw clearly because we are using in environment mask. That's why we could not saw clearly. If you are rendering in Lumiere or Enscape will be so equally. So I will skip the past and I hope you understand this situation, because we're using for texture, it's sometimes it's hardly to see, but of course when we start rendering we'll see it more clearly, as you can see here. So I think here is perfect. I'm going to turn it off for shape first, then I can select all of them here, go to filter, then check none, select only curtain panel, hit apply, then hit OK. Let me hide element first. Okay, once I hide that, what I'm going to do next, I'm going to create create our component. Go to our reference, make sure you turn on for 3D snapping, start for line there, then I'm going to connect that. Just simply connect here, start from here until here, hit escape, then start from here until here, hit escape, and again I'm going to continue there. Start from here. Hit escape. The edge here for structural support with our element. So now we done that. What I'm going to do that I'm going to create our point. But in the case I will using for round steel, it's quite strong than simple rectangle steel, hollow section. So I'm going to set a plane first. Just set for vertical. Using circle, start from here and make it for 40 dimension, turn our scale to 1 by 5, hit escape, select my dimension here, assign for a new material parameter, sorry, assign for a parameter not a material, so I'm going to make it for structure size. Perfect. Now what I'm going to do next, I'm going to select here all, then select here all again, then CO for copy, start from back here for front, then I'm going to copy that multiple, start copy here one, let's be unconstrained first. Hit escape. Perfect. Now I saw my dimension here is quite messy. I'm going to hide this guy over there first. VG for visibility graphic, go to annotation, then just turn off for dimension there, hit apply, then hit OK. So now it's time to pick our elements, select the center point here. Make sure you select only the center point to activate the pick a new host. I'm going to pick here and another guy there. Maybe I need to create one more. I'm going to copy again, unconstrained, hit escape, select point here, pick a new point, and I'm going to pick on top here. Let me turn around first. Okay, perfect. So it's time to create our structure form. I'm going to select here 1 and 2. Just simply create solid form. Okay, sorry, hit escape first, select here again, select one reference only, just continue my process here. Perfect. Okay, we are almost done. Okay, this one we picked out already. Okay, perfect. One, I done my structure element, but this guy over there is wrong already, as you can see here, so I would like to delete first. Okay, one, I done my structural element. Okay, here is a fake also, so I'm going to paste another one. Make sure you select your structure properly when you apply for solid form. It's not that you will face the problem like me. And of course, there I need to assign a material as well, a parameter as well. As you can see here, this is the problem. So I'm going to hit escape first. Select only my one reference line. Select here again. Create a solid form, as you can see here. So now it's perfect. So I'm going to select all of them there. Then just simply go to filter, check none, only curtain panel, because I want to assign a new material as well. Create a new material here. Now I would like to using for spray paint. Spray paint for my steel structure. Go to our appearance library again. Then go to our wall paint. I would like to using for dark red. It's applied and it's okay. Then I just simply turn on for my reset temporary first. Okay, perfect. Once I done that, I can adjustment my structure also for parameter, and this guy over there also can change that. Let's testing out. Let's say I want to testing only for this point. I want to offset for facade structure for 400. It apply. As you can see here, then I can make it for 3250. Okay, I think 250 is perfect. Now we got a complex facade there. It I turn on for realistic. As you can see here, it's quite nice. So I'm going to load into our project. Just load into our project here. Project 1, then it's okay. Go to our 3D there. Okay, there I need to activate for 3D also. Then I'm going to press 1 by 1. CM for shortcut key. Then I'm going to start from top here. Let me see first. Hit the sketch. I will delete the previous one first. Okay, I don't like this position. Basically, I want to rotate that. So I'm going to start place from 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I'm going to delete first. See them again. 1, 2. Okay, I like this position. Hit escape. Because I want my structure is wrapped around here. Basically, for this kind of structure, when applying in reality construction, you might be need to add some structure to support here. It's make it a bit more longer. Then we're using our steel plate for support with our bow and not to join with our concrete element from facade there. And now we almost finished already. So what I'm going to do next, I'm going to just repeat our process here. We'll be repeating, as you can see here. We got quite nice structural element. Then I just hit finish up. Once I done that, I'm going to my level 1 architecture. I'm going to create a simple column there, just using column. Then using our extrusion. And of course, I will make it more bigger. Just make it for 2 meter. Hit escape. Then I'm going to move this guy in here. Just move in like this, hit escape. Then I'm going to assign for new material as well. Create new material. Just make it for spray paint. Apply, it's okay. Then I just hit finish again. Once I done that, I will start from sound elevation. Then I'm going to drag up until top. Make it like this, go to our 3D. Then I just hit finish up. go to our join. I'm going to join this guy over there. Hit a sketch first. Let me join you guy. Okay, we could not join, but I know how to solve that. Just start from the right place here. Then I can just drag it down. Okay, perfect. One, I done that. The reason I draw the column there because easier for 3D perspective with Session Bob when you want to create a seal for print. Okay, as you can see here, it's quite perfect. It's quite nice. And our structural element is kind support is properly, as you can see here. Then I'm going to open up my Section Bob there because I want to make it more smaller. Easier for you guys understand about that, and when you want to print also easy. Let's make it like this. Right click, high end view, high element. Okay, perfect. As you can see here, it perfect here. Our element, structural element, is also running properly, and we got a two different material for our facade design. Okay guys, I think it's pretty much for this tutorial. I hope you got learned something new about this tutorial. Thank you guys for watching from start to finish, and if you like the tutorial, make sure thumbs up, like and subscribe if you are first time reaching out here, because your like and your subscriber is motivate me to bring more professional content about Revit. Thank you for watching, and I see you for another tutorial in Revit, and have a nice day. Thank you.